Okay, so we learned for I think the last few months we've been learning the halachot of Shabbat, and I thought it's about time that we learn halachot of davening, praying on Shabbat, davening on Shabbat. We daven every Shabbat. We know the halachot of davening on Shabbat, and still I feel it's a great idea to learn go over it again. Okay, so we'll go over the halachot, and our main siman that we'll be learning, I'll open it in the Shulchan Aruch, it's Reish Samech Chet, okay, 268. That's the main siman that we are learning. I think my internet is a bit slow. Let me just try and understand why. Okay, let's hope the internet doesn't do too many problems. And we are in Siman Reish Samechet 268. He talked mainly about mistakes in the Tfilat of Shabbat, and not only mistakes, also what do you do for different paths of davening, like Vayechul. Okay, so let's begin from Vayechulu. That is the first Sa'if in the Shulchan Aruch, Reish Samechet 268. Says the Shulchan Aruch, you say Vayechulu in the davening of Arvit. So in Shmoneh Esre, we mention Vayechulu, and in a few moments, so we'll also discuss the Vayechulu that we repeat after Shacharit. So now we are, we say Vayechulu in Shacharit, in Arvit, sorry, in Maariv we say Vayechulu, and we'll discuss soon. Vayechulu we say after Arvit. Mistakes. So the common mistake we have on Shabbat, we daven davening of Shabbat and we pray, especially on Maariv, we're still in Mincha of Yom Chol, and we say, "Oh, Slach lana v'lu ki chatanu," right? And this moving our hand tells us, "One second, it is now not Yom Chol; it's now Shabbat. It's Shabbos now." So what do you do when we have a mistake and mention by mistake the prayers of Yom Chol? To understand this siman, we need to first know that originally or theoretically, even on Shabbat, we could say Shmoneh Esre. Even on Shabbat, we could say Shmoneh Esre. Shmoneh Esre are prayers for all of the week and theoretically also for Shabbat. The Gemara gives a few reasons why we say Shmoneh Esre, different maybe parts of the body, different. So there is a reason for saying Shmoneh Esre every day. There's a few reasons why, in the end, we do not say the, all of the 18 blessings, all of Shmoneh Esre, why we do not say them on Shabbat. Okay, but first, to begin with, otherwise we won't be able to understand the next Sa'if. In all of the Shacharit, Mincha, and Arvit, all the three prayers of Shabbat, okay, which means Shacharit, Mincha, and Arvit, theoretically we could say Shmoneh Esre, we could say the 18 blessings. There's two reasons why not. One, as is, the prayer on Shabbat is long, right? It's long, and people want to get home already and eat, and the prayer on Shabbat is long. So Chazal didn't want to make the prayer of Shabbat even longer. So they said, okay, we won't have 18 blessings on Shabbat, 19 blessings on Shabbat. The prayer will have only 77 blessings on Shabbat. Okay, so that is a very important reason of why we don't say Shmoneh Esre on Shabbat. Another reason is that, and I think that we mentioned a bit in the past, that we do ask for things on Shabbat. Okay, we say Mishaberach Lachole on Shabbat for someone who isn't feeling well. But Shabbat isn't supposed to be a day of asking for our small and personal things. It's supposed to be like Olam Haba, like a day where we, as if, feel that everything we need, we already have it and we can rest. So that's what Chazal said. That's the second reason for the fact that we don't say the regular blessings on Shabbat. We have a shorter version. Okay, so as I mentioned, Originally, we could say, we should have said all of the blessings of the regular weekday blessings on Shabbat. Chazal said Shabbat will make it shorter. And why am I saying that? Because that brings us to the Sa'if, next Sa'if in Shulchan Aruch. A person starts Shmoneh Esrei, starts married, and all of a sudden he realized that he's in the middle of saying the blessings of Yom Chol. And he started at Tachonen, he started Slach Lanu, he said Shema Koleinu, whatever. He's already in the middle of saying the blessing of Yom Chol. And since, theoretically, as we said, the blessing of Yom Chol is connected to Shabbat, he finishes this blessing. Okay, so a person started saying, and after saying this whole sentence, you realize, 1 second, it's now Shabbat. What do I do? And the answer will be, he'll finish this bracha. Okay, he'll finish this bracha, and then go back to Shabbat. So if a person started atachonel adam dat, he'll finish the blessing of atachonel adam dat, and afterwards we'll go back to Shabbat. Like Ibashta, Ata Echad, Ismach Moshe, whatever will be the blessing of Shabbat. But if he started the blessing of Yom Chol, he finishes the blessing of Yom Chol. Okay, and many times I think it catches us when we say Slach Lanu, we hit our heart and all, and then we realize, 1 second, it's not Shabbat. We'll finish Slach Lanu, and then we'll go back to the blessing of Shabbat. Okay, and that's true for Shacharit, Mincha, and Arvit. And the reason is, as we mentioned, because theoretically, Shacharit, Mincha, and Arvit, we could have said all the 18 blessings. So therefore, if we started the blessing of Yom Chol of the weekday, we finished that blessing. Here comes the question. What happens on Musaf? Okay, Musaf is a totally different prayer. Totally different prayer. The three prayers of Arvit, Shachrit, and Mincha are very similar, also in the names, to the weekday blessings. They come for Korbanot, they come because of Abraham, Yitzchak, and Yaakov. They established the idea of those blessings. But Musaf is something totally different. Musaf does not exist on Yom Chol. Okay, it's only for Shabbat or for Yom Tov or Chodesh. There's no Musaf on a weekday prayer. Therefore, the person started on Musaf, in Musaf. The person started one of the weekday's blessings. He stops in the middle of a blessing and corrects himself and goes back to Musaf. Okay, so that's for the difference between Musaf and the other three prayers. Okay, so the other three prayers, Arvit, Shachrit, and Mincha. If a person started one of the prayers of Yom Chol of the weekday, he finishes the blessing and then he goes back. Continued Shabbat, and Musaf stops in the middle of the blessing. Okay, so that's Saif. Going on, if you are following me in Shulchan Aruch, Reish Samechet, we are moving now to Saif Gimel. And here we have continuing the same topic of if a person by mistake started prayer of Yom Chol. He started the prayer of Yom Chol. Then usually we know it's Shabbat. Usually we look around, we know it's Shabbat, and we know it's Shabbat. We aren't so much paying attention to the davening. So by mistake, we start Atachonel Adam Dat. There's the Shulchan Aruch. Can you see the Shulchan Aruch? If he began the blessing, okay, he says Atah. He didn't continue, just said Atah. Okay, Atah. He didn't even say Atah Chonen, said Atah. He moves to the Shabbat prayer. He moves the Shabbat blessing. And why is that? If you look at Arvit, what's the prayer for Arvit? Atah Kidashta. It starts with the word Atah, you. If we look at the prayer of and the blessing of Mincha, so how does the blessing of Shabbat start with? Ata echad, shimcha echad. So since the word ata, if we only the word ata belongs to Shabbat, we can say the word ata also on Mariv, also on Mincha. The word atah isn't really the beginning of atah chonen adam dat, which is the blessing of the weekday. It could theoretically be also the blessing for Shabbat. So therefore, if a person just said atah, and then he realized, 1 second, I cannot say atah chonen, it's not a weekday, it's Shabbos. So he continues and moves to the blessing of Shabbat. Okay, so that's Seif Gimel and to drink. We'll continue in Seif Dalet. Another mistake we can have is if a person didn't mention Shabbat at all. If he didn't mention Shabbat at all, he's not Yotzei Deyechova. It's not the same Yehovah. If he mentioned Shabbat, and as well, even if he mentioned, he got mixed up between the prayers of Shabbat, he mentioned Shabbat, so is Yotzeh. But if a person did not mention Shabbat at all, he needs to repeat the prayer. And so if a person having the regular weekday prayer and he forgot it's Shabbat, he needs to repeat the prayer. If he remembered before he finished the prayer, so it's like, reminds very much someone who forgot Ya'aleh Ve'yavo. If he davened, he got to Modim, said Sim Shalom, before he finished the prayer, he said, 1 second, it's Shabbos, I forgot to say the prayer for Shabbat. He just goes back. He goes back to the prayer, to the blessing of Shabbat, and then continues Shmoneh Esrei. Okay, so if a person davened, for example, got to Retzeh. He started Retzeh, and then he realized, 1 second, I didn't mention Shabbat. He goes back, says, Atakitashta, or Ismach Moshe, or Atayachad, whatever blessing it is, depending if it's Mariv, Shachrit, or Mincha. And then he just continues. So he says, Atakitashta, then he says, Retze, Modim, and Sim Shalom. So if you remembered in the middle of the prayer, he goes back, says the blessing of Shabbat, and continues. If he finished all the prayer, he needs to repeat it again and start from the beginning of the prayer. That's relatively simple halacha. What happens if a person got mixed up? And at night time, he mentioned the blessing of Shachrit, or maybe on Shachrit, he mentioned the blessing of Mincha. He got mixed up between the prayers. Okay, between the prayers. And here again, we see the difference between the three prayers and between Musaf. So Shachrit, Mincha, and Mariv, they stand as one group, and Musaf stands for itself. Okay? Why is that? By the way, if I'm moving too fast, so raise your hand and let me know. Okay? So Shachrit, Mincha, and Mariv, of the idea of the prayers, of the idea of the blessing inside the prayer of Shabbat, is to sanctify the Shabbat. It's true. We use different words. Okay, Chazal gave us different wording to use. Once we say Atakidashta, we say Atamechartanu, Ismach Moshe, we mentioned Vayechulu, we mentioned Vashamu Vnei Israel. All of the idea, all the those blessings have one idea. Shabbat is sanctified, Shabbat is elevated, Shabbat is different than the regular weekdays. So if by mistake in Mincha I mentioned the davening of Shabbat, Shachrit, and in Shachrit I mentioned the davening of Mariv, okay, I mean, we shouldn't do it, but it's fine. I do not need to repeat the prayer since I said the prayer. I said what I'm supposed to say, and that is sanctifying Shabbat. We sanctify Shabbat. Okay, in Musaf it's different. In Musaf, we need to mention the korbanot, okay, or mention the special sacrifice of Musaf, the korban of Musaf, that we used to bring in the time of the temple, of the Beis HaMikdash. That is the main part of Musaf, mentioning the korban. So if a person did not mention the korban of Musaf, so he's not Yotzei Dechor. Okay, so if a person, for example, said Musaf, said of Musaf, he davened Shachrit twice. Okay, so obviously, for Shachrit is good, for Musaf, it's not good, and he needs to repeat and say Musaf. Okay, so he needs to repeat and say Musaf. And the Rama mentions that even if a person for Musaf just mentioned a bit of the korbanot. He said, we will do in front of you the korbanot of Shabbat, of the Musaf of Shabbat, that's fine. But the person must mention the korbanot in the davening of Musaf. Okay, it can be a shorter form than what we have, but we must mention the korbanot. Okay, so if we want to repeat it, if a person davened shachrit twice, he's not yotzei ydei chovah Musaf. The same if he davened by mistake Musaf twice. Instead of davening shachrit, davened Musaf twice. So Musaf is fine, he's yotzei Musaf, he does not need to repeat Musaf, but he needs to repeat shachrit. He needs to say shacharit again. Okay, so if a person got mixed up between mincha, mariv, and or mariv, mincha, and shacharit, he's yotzei ydei chovah. Okay, if he says instead of ata echad, he says ata kidashta, he's yotzei ydei chovah. If a person in Musa mentioned the davening of shacharit, or in shacharit he mentioned the davening of Musaf, he is not yotzei ydei chovah. Okay, and he needs to repeat the davening. Okay, so that is the halachot of getting mixed up between different paths of davening. We can see here, as before we continue, that although Chazal said to us each prayer should have something special, something unique in it, each blessing we say, even Birkat HaMazon, even the blessings we say before Shema, each one has its own words. All of those long blessings have a core. And the core is the most important part of the blessing. So as soon as we said the core, the main sentence of the blessing, even if afterwards we got mixed up, it's fine. Okay, so it's fine. Okay, and I'm going now to Seif Vav. We reached Seif Vav. Let's go to Seif Vav. In Reish Samechet. If have we learned, going to see if Zayin. At the night time, we mentioned that we say Bayechulu. So you say Bayechulu in the night time as part of Pilat Lachash, part of the Amidah, we say quietly, we say Bayechulu. I established to repeat Bayechulu again after Arvit. Okay, so after Arvit, we repeat Vayechulu again. The reason for repeating it again is because on Yom Tov, if Yom Tov falls on Shabbat, we don't say Vayechulu, we daven quietly. And Chazal wanted everyone to say Vayechulu together in Shul, so they said that we repeat Vayechulu again. Since there are some weeks when the Yom Tov is on Shabbat, we don't say Vayechulu quietly in the Amidah, we'll say it afterwards again. Another reason is because Vayechulu is a very important part of Shmoneh Esreh on Shabbat night, and we'll soon expand why. And some people, especially in the past, they didn't know how to daven, and they could more or less read or say a bit. They didn't know how to say Vayechulu in davening the Amidah. Therefore, Chazal said, we will repeat Vayechulu again after the Amidah. And as we know, on Shabbat night, we repeat Vayechulu. Says the Shulchan Aruch that we say Vayechulu loud, like we do say Vayechulu loud, and the Me'umad, standing up. Okay, standing up. Here comes an interesting question with an answer. Why do we have to stand up when we say Vayechulu? Why stand up? Why can't we sit down? And the explanation is, as brought in the Poskim, that Vayechulu is like testifying on Hashem creating the world. So when we say Vayechulu quietly in davening, and then we repeat and we say Vayechulu everyone together, it's like we are testifying on Hashem creating the world in 6 days and then resting on Shabbat. So if Vayechulu is testifying, that's why we stand up, because witnesses used to stand up, should stand up when they testify. Here comes the question. If I am davening by myself at home, I don't have a minyan. Do I say vayechulu? Do I repeat and say vayechulu? On one hand, Chazal said, say vayechulu. So, say every Shabbat. On the other hand, if vayechulu is like a testimony, it's like testifying for the Hashem did, so say, oh, you have to have at least two witnesses or at least two people when you say vayechulu. Okay, so that is the question.
Except that we...
Oh, yeah,
we say it in Kiddush, though.
We say it in Kiddush again, right?
We say it in Kiddush.
In Kiddush, we say it. Some stand up in Kiddush. For example, my minhag, that's what the Rama writes, to stand up when we say Vayechulu in Kiddush. There, it doesn't necessarily have a testimony on Hashem. In Shul, okay, in Shul, part of it maybe is like a testifying that Hashem created the world. And usually testifying, we need two people. So it's actually a machloket. You are right. It is a machloket. It's a machloket. Some say, some hold. You know? In Kiddush we say, and you say Kiddush by yourself, it's not a testimony. It's just a mentioning Hashem created the world. It doesn't have it. So we aren't witnesses in the aspect of going to judge and standing in court and standing. And you need two people. It's not. It's just mentioning. It took him. So some hold that... let's say you davened long and the Chassan was very, very fast and you didn't manage to say Vayechulu with everyone, and hold, it's fine. Just open a Siddur and say Vayechulu and you don't need to ask anyone else to say Vayechulu with you. Okay, so that there's an opinion like that. Yeah, the Taz, okay, the Taz, the Turei Zahav, one of the early Achronim on the Shulchan Aruch, he said that the person davening alone does not say Vayechulu. Okay, because he even looks at it as a group. You need a minyan to say Vayechulu. Okay, you need to be in a minyan. Okay? Everyone says that by himself. It needs to be something of a minyan. Etta, okay? Community. Something very important. The community says Vayechulu together. So you can't, if, when you daven by yourself at home, you do not say Vayechulu. Some hold that at least you should say Vayechulu with two people together. Okay, you can't say Vayechulu alone. And in the end, the Taz concludes that if a person wants to say Vayechulu when he's alone, he can say. But his intention would be that he's reading a few psukim. He's not testifying on Hashem. He's not testifying on the Hashem creating the world. He's just reading a few psukim. If you want to summarize it, if it's a Yudavan, by yourself at home, or you don't have a minyan for any reason, so you say Vayechulu, but you should have in mind as if you're just reading Tzukim and you aren't testifying on Hashem creating the world in 6 days. If you're in Shul and you daven slower than the Chazan, or the Chazan daven faster than you, depends how you look at it, you should ask someone else to say Vayechulu together with you, and that's the regular custom. That's what people do. And see, we have only 5 minutes. We'll try to speed up a bit. After Vayechulu, we say Bracha Achat Me'ein Sheva. It's we won't go into the reason why, but because I want the people to stay in Shul for a bit longer on Shabbat nights. I'll ask here a riddle, okay, a question, a trivia question, and you can send the answer on the WhatsApp. Sometimes, every few years, we have one Shabbat that we do not say Vayechulu on Friday night. Okay, so that's a trivia question. The answer can be sent in the WhatsApp. Every few years, we have one Shabbat we don't say, Me'ein Sheva. We don't say Magen Avot. Magen Avot, Bizvaro, Mechayem. So we don't say it on Friday night. One Shabbat every few years. You know the answer, send it in the WhatsApp. So we say Me'ein Sheva. Me'ein Sheva we say when there's a minyan, only when there's a minyan, and only when it's a minyan where we daven there in a permanent way. It's just a temporary place. So we don't say Me'ein Sheva. Okay, we don't say Magen Avot. If we are there for a few days and we brought a Sefer Torah there and they say we're staying in a hotel for a whole week and we have the room where we daven, so we say Me'ein Sheva also there. But the question, during COVID for months, okay, for months, a community davened outside in a certain place. And the question is, do they say Me'ein Sheva? Do they say Magen Avot outside of Shul or not? Based on that, I think they do say Me'ein Sheva, they do say Magen Avot. because that's a permanent place for much more than a week. It was for many, many weeks. They davened in that place, although it wasn't inside the shul, it was outside of the shul. I think they say Me'ein Sheva, Magen Avot, in such a case. Okay, so Magen Avot, we say only when there's a minyan and only inside the shul. And I'm skipping a bit because of the time. Based on that, if there's Chas V'Cheila and Avel, and for some reason they're davening in the house of the Avel, or on a more happy occasion, it used to be in the past, when there's a Chatan, and they're davening in the house of the Chatan before the wedding, so you do not say Magen Avot at that place. Okay, Magen Avot is only in a shul with a minyan. Okay, Me'ein Sheva, it's maybe something which is a good reminder. In general speaking, we shouldn't be speaking in shul. Okay, we shouldn't be speaking in shul, especially not when the Chazan happens. But especially for Me'ein Sheva and Vayechulu, since it's something which all the community should be saying together. In Vayechulu, we should be testifying of Hashem creating the world. So we shouldn't be that talking while community says Vayechulu. And the same when the Chazan says Magen Avot, we shouldn't be talking, we should listen to him. One last halacha about Me'ein Sheva. Let it is someone who doesn't know the davening of Shabbat night. He doesn't know the davening of Shabbat night. So it's not so practical for today, but just interesting to know, interesting halacha, how important Me'ein Sheva, how important Magen Avot is. If he listens to the Chazan from the beginning to the end, and it's just a regular Shabbat, he listens to the Chazan from the beginning to the end, and hears the Chazan saying, Magen Avot B'Dvaro, right? And all of that section, so he's Yotzei Dechova, the prayer of Shabbat. Okay, Bracha Me'ein Sheva takes the seven blessings of Shabbat, puts it into one bracha, and therefore, if someone doesn't know the davening, the prayer, and he hears that from the Chazan, and he had in mind to be Yotzei, so he's Yotzei Dechova, and he does not need to repeat, he does not need to daven the davening of Shabbat night. As I said, today we know the davening. We can open the siddur, we can read, but it's just interesting halacha to know how important this prayer is. And I think we will conclude here, since you have Arvit very soon. Zot Hashem, we'll meet next week again.